In this video, you're going to see the presentation that I delivered at the Google Teacher Summit in March in London. It's not the actual recording from the Google Teacher Summit. It's actually just me in a classroom with some of my students, but it gives you an idea about the presentation. And I also go through all the demonstration of how we use Google Data Studio here at Suffolk New College. Right at the end of the video, I'm going to give you a link to the presentation so you can have a play around with the demonstration files and change the reports yourself and see how they work in practice. Hi, I'm Darren. I'm from Suffolk New College. I'm a developmental coach at Suffolk New College and also a lecturer on the initial teacher training program. I specialise in technology in education, but also doing curriculum design as well and how you can use that within your curriculum. Today, I'm going to be talking you through how we use interactive reports using Google Data Studio. And just a bit of background to begin with. So why we actually started using Google Data Studio. First of all, we wanted to develop our digital skills within the college, and we wanted to create 10% of our cohort, of our provision, was going to be delivered online. And we wanted to know where the staff were currently at. It was a two-year program. And at the start of the program, we wanted to assess all the staff's digital literacy skills. So we gave them a self-assessment form that they filled in and then had to complete. We also wanted then to target training sessions for them. So we wanted to analyse that data and work out where our training resource could be best used and how we can support the teams to develop their digital literacy skills and also their digital content. And then finally, we also wanted to give the managers a view to be able to filter that results and see their team view so they could actually then analyse and see their own team's data and know where their skills were needed within that provision. So with those three things in mind, we decided to collect nearly 200 teaching staff on their digital literacy skills with a nice form here with lots of numbers. And we wanted to demonstrate that in a way that the staff and the managers could then use. So our solution initially was to use Google Sheets. And we were going to use that to analyse the data. But when we demoed it with the managers, they found they really struggled with the filtered view options within Google Sheets. And also, there was quite a lot of confusion when another manager filtered the original data and that changed the whole view for everybody else. So we realised that wasn't necessarily our best solution. So we went back to the drawing board and, like everybody does, we Googled the solution. And the solution came across Google Data Studio as a potential program we could then actually use with our results. So Google Data Studio is a free product that's part of the Google marketing platform. So it's a bit different from Google for Education, but it's free and you can use it and you can use your Google for Education account to access it. You can analyse any data from a range of sources, including sheets, without the need for code, which is bonus for us. None of us could code, so it was easier to just do drag and drop and create it. So we didn't need to code for it. And also the final report could then be shared just with a simple web link and you get a unique view of it. So the managers weren't seeing what other managers were doing, they could filter it and see their own responses, and every time they went back to it, it returned back to the default view as well. So I've got some demos to show you how it actually works. So this is our digital literacy analysis, this is our first demo. So I've just, some of this data is live data, but it's being filtered for GDPR purposes. But what you're going to see here, this is our overview. So down here across here is our overview of the whole college. So this is where people fill their skills are within the college. So if it's 3.9, that's very high because the highest one was 4. The lowest grade is a 2. Lowest grade is a 1 that they can put in. So something down here with 2.1, that would be where a training need would be for it. And what we can do over here, we can filter it by school. So let's just filter it by a different school and let's select English and Maths, for instance. So this is now showing me the average for that school, and we can see where there's some really strengths are and some areas which they need some development for. We've also got the staff down here, and we've got which level they achieve and which level they're working towards. And if I just scroll down to the bottom here, we've also got a pie chart just explaining that most of the staff here are working towards intermediate level, some have got basic level, and some are working towards what's known as innovation, so that's beyond mastery, they're like the top staff that we find in this self-assessment. On the next page, you can create different pages for the different reports. On this second page, it's kept the idea of the schools that we looked at, so it's still got the English and Maths team we're having a look at here. And on this page, I can now filter this form to see where my training need would be for particular staff. So let's go for I6, which was a need. If I click it once, what it's going to show me is the ones who grade themselves the highest within that area. And if I click it again, it's then going to show me the ones that scored themselves the lowest within that particular category. So I can see those that scored 1 to 2, they're the staff that we'll then have to work with this particular skill. And that one is all about using digital tools to enable accessibility with my students. On the next page here, what we can then see here is the school as a whole, and we can see where the training need is. So the ones which are highlighted here are the ones that scored themselves 1 or 2. So we can see again, I6 is the highest one that we'd need for that training need. If I go back here and unfilter and actually see the whole college again, I can then see across the whole college where the training need would be for each school, really clearly visually represented. And again, I can see that I6 is the one that I need to have the most support with. Over 100 staff would need support with those. They grade themselves over 1 or 2 for their accessibility. So let's find, I need to find a trainer to support me with that. If I go to our final page on here, I'm now going to try and find a trainer, so who scored themselves highly on that particular one. So let's go down to I6, and I'm going to say, I just want to see those that scored themselves a 4. And again, it's now going to give me a list here of those staff members that scored themselves 4 for that particular competency. And I can then ask them if they could support us with delivering training for those. So it's a really great interactive report that can filter and find out the information that we need to support us within those. If I go back to the next one, this is our next attempt when we then started to bring in blended learning. We wanted to know what staff were using for blended learning, how it was working, and we added some colour into it so we can quickly analyse if they are a positive or maybe a negative. And I'm going to be able to select my program area again. So this time, once this loads up, I'm just going to select art and design, IT and electronics, just an example. And what I can see from this team is that they use Google Suites for most of their working. So 9 out of the 10 staff use it. But I can also see that they're not using Padlet. So I might target some training sessions around using Padlet and how they can bring in Google products into their Padlet and support that with their students. I can also see over here that they're really keen about developing their e-resources and devoting time to develop the blended learning within those, so we know they're a really sort of proactive department. But if I go to our next page here, I can see, are they actually using any of those approaches right now? So for instance, none of the staff here are using online discussions, for instance, and that might be something we want to support them with so they can do learning outside the lessons and have online discussions. Similarly as well, in here, work that's set outside class isn't always required for the following lesson. So there might be some curriculum changes we need to think about and support that team with creating a more blended approach in the future. And the final demo here is about comparing results over time. So it's not just about that initial kind of data, it's about looking at how things may be changed. So they might ask, for instance, a survey results, which you ask 3 times in a year. What we do on our teacher training program, we have module feedback, and that's done at the end of each module. We get the evaluations for each module. So I'm just going to filter one particular module here, so module 4. And we can see when we ask this most recently, so this quarter, so this term, we ask this, you know, are they satisfied with teaching in the module? And that's had a 25% decline from the previous time that we asked that in the last semester. But we have saw an increase here of 20%. I received feedback from the tutor that helped me to learn, and that got increased of 6%. So again, that's just demo data, and we can see at the bottom here when the students then actually completed that form, which date they completed it, and what grade they also put when they graded that as well. So we can see that changing over time and how that's developed, and given us an indication whether it's improved or declined on a particular question that we asked the students to do. So just kind of summarise about it. We obviously think Google Data Studio is a great alternative way of creating interactive reports from using Google Sheets. It gives a really nice way feel for your data, and obviously it gives you an opportunity to filter that in the way that's right for you as a manager. It automatically updates as well, so we're always going to see the most up-to-date data. So even if a member of staff now filled in that survey, that self-assessment report, it would update on our tracking sheet and we'd be able to see it in our report. And there's also loads of customization options as well to make the report look the way that you want it to look. Just a few sort of areas to consider if you are now thinking this could be a good idea to explore. The first thing, it does take a little practice to understand the terminology that's used within the program, especially if you're used to spreadsheets. You just have to spend a bit of time working out what that means and how that impacts the data that you're seeing. And also, it's very much aimed towards businesses. So there's loads of templates available, but might not be appropriate for education. Thanks for watching the video. Here's the link to my slides, so you can have a play yourself on those demo reports and see how they work in practice. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching.